that rocked Los Angeles, 10-year-old Anthony Avalos was tortured and murdered, allegedly, by his own mother and her boyfriend in 2019. New outrage surrounding the case as L.A. District Attorney George Gascón announced Thursday the county will drop the death penalty charges for the accused. Anthony's aunt and uncle, Maria Barron and David Barron, and criminal defense attorney Brian Claypool join me now. Thank you all for being here on this topic. Maria, let's start with you first. Your reaction to Gascón's office saying that they're not going to pursue the death penalty in Anthony's case.
Good morning. Well, I'm angry, first of all. I already knew going into court that the death penalty was going to be off the table. Just looking at the reaction of Heather and Kareem just kind of broke me inside. It's not fair, you know? They deserve the worst possible punishment there is. You know, what kind of rehabilitation are they going to do? You know, they chose to torture Anthony and do all these awful things to them. So they shouldn't receive any mercy whatsoever.
You know, David, the justification being given from Gascón's office, some of it anyway, is that the death penalty would yield appeals that would be traumatizing to this family. As far as I can see it, taking the death penalty off the table is traumatizing to the family.
Yes, it is. They did the worst crime there is. They needed to get the worst punishment. There is no justice for Anthony until we can get the furthest punishment pursued for this case.
You know, Brian, what's shocking to me about this is that when I saw it was that Gascón apparently failed to review any of the files, look at the materials, didn't look at the photographs. So how was this decision made? And are you surprised at all, given what's been coming out of the Gascón office for some time now?
Yeah, if ever there was a poster child case for the death penalty in California, it's this one. And just so your viewers know, prior to November, when Gascón was elected, the DA, Jackie Lacey, she impaneled a committee for 6 months to review all the evidence in this case to determine whether the death penalty should be implemented on this case. This was not an overnight decision. Then Gascón gets elected. Not one time did he speak to John Hatami, the prosecutor. Not one time did he review the file. Not one time did he review the 100 photographs of Anthony's dead body. I personally reviewed those photographs at the DA's office. He was bruised from head to toe. His groin area was bruised. So in effect, what Gascón has done is he is using a tortured, sexually molested, and murdered 10-year-old boy to promote his radical social experiment.
Maria, your final thoughts to Gascón's office on this?
You know, it's just, he sits there and says that going into the death penalty phase that we would have to go through all this stuff. Well, we're living it right now. Every day is a constant struggle, just thinking that Anthony's not going to get the justice he deserves. My baby boy deserves all the justice, and Gascón is getting in the way of that.
Maria and David, thank you for being here. Our hearts go out to you for your loss. Brian, thank you as well. We'll continue to follow the story. We appreciate it. Anthony Avalos was 10 years old. Just 10 years old. We'll be right back.